It's not the end. It's the beginning. Treating macular hole is a day-to-day practice for a vitreoretinal surgeon. Addressing anterior posterior and tangential traction by classic ILM peeling is the key of success for macular hole surgery. But even in the best hand, this can fail and results in non-closure of hole like this. For larger holes, inverse flap technique is adopted for better hole closure than classic method. But in a failed case after peeled ILM, the option is to plug this residual hole with free ILM flap like this case. Few surgeons have tried with lens capsular flap, autologous blood, etc. In these cases, hole is closed, but SDOCT analysis shows it is filled with scar tissue only. Then a new idea came to my mind. If we can replace it with retinal tissue so that the gap can be filled with functional retinal graft. We have designed a series of trephine of different sizes. Preoperatively, after measuring the hole size, we choose a trephine of 100 micron larger size. After residual vitrectomy, a suitable area is chosen and retinal trephination done with gentle rotation. The graft is freed with a scissor and held with the forceps at the margin with utmost care. The graft is placed over the hole gently with photoreceptor side down, then tucked with soft tip cannula. This is done under air and residual fluid is taken out. Donor site lasered properly, followed by gas tamponade. Curiously, I was waiting for the result and I saw the hole was closed with the graft and the well-taken graft was having architecture somewhat similar to adjoining area. Now a question arised: is the graft functioning? To understand, we did multifocal electroretinogram and wow, it's amazing. Amazing response at macular area, showing significant macular spike. And we performed Humphrey visual field of 10-2 as well, which also showed near normal foveal threshold of 25 to 27 decibels. Till now, we have done 7 cases with minimum follow-up of 1 year up to maximum of 3.5 years. In this series, we have 70% cases with graft in place, vision improved in 40% cases and rest with stable vision. Though the number is small, but being a rare condition of primary failed surgery, number 7 is significant enough for establishing the fact. Literature says few surgeons have tried putting autologous retinal patch graft in these cases, but they have used larger size graft without trephination, which probably acts as a scaffold. There is no end-to-end touch. In our method, predetermined size of retinal trephination done and tucked into the hole to have end-to-end touch. and we hypothesize that an aberrant regeneration takes place at this graft host junction. To prevent any hindrance into it, we did not use any viscoelastic agent or liquid perfluorocarbon. To show you the comparison, this is a multifocal ERG in a normal macula. Here it is a case of closed hole with classic ILM peeling. In this case, it is failed hole closed with ILM free flap. And this is our case of macular grafting. Please do see on a single chart. This encouraging multifocal ERG response indirectly proves our hypothesis of aberrant regeneration of neural connection. Also, automated perimetry supports this fully. The key of success here is harvesting exact size of retinal graft by trephination and not using any substance which can hinder end-to-end touch. A larger series can open up a new horizon of retinal grafting. Thank you.
Okay. Why under air and not under PFCL?
Yeah, that was there should not be, the idea is there should not be any hindrance between the end-to-end touch. So the hypothesis is that compared to the other surgeons what they're doing, here the end-to-end touch, if the PFCL, they, you know, seeps into it, or the viscoelastic agent seeps into it, so that there cannot be a direct touch. So that was the idea of not using any viscoelastic agent or PFCL. It is done under air, and it is tucked into, the margins are tucked into the hole.
What is the largest hole size that you take up? What is the largest size that you have taken?
1200 micron size I have. In our series, it is not included here, but till now I have done is 1200 micron series size of the trephine.
So the trephine must be 21 gauge then?
Yeah, so one port, the sequence will be after doing vitrectomy, it is already vitrectomized eye, so you put the chandelier light pipe and one port has been enlarged to a 20 gauge, and according the size of the trephine, you go inside and then trephine it and put it there. The procedure is first is under fluid, we do the trephination. Then we take out with the left hand, we take out the graft is taken out. And then with the right hand, I do the fluid air exchange and then I put it there.
I have a different question. I'm not a retina guy. How much video clip you have taken from Karate Kid? What is the time frame?
I need to see.
In seconds.
8 seconds.
30 seconds, seconds. 37 seconds. How much you can take for including an in video? It is not Creative Common video. It is a commercial movie. So how much you can take for your presentation officially and legally?
8 seconds.
10 seconds rule. 10 seconds rules are there. You must know that because this is Copyright Act and these are not commercial forum, but you can take 3:10, 9:99, but you cannot take 37 seconds odd seconds. I was watching that. You cannot take that actually. Even music. You cannot. You have Creative Common platform. You can take a lot of videos or music from them without any Copyright Act infringement. Thank you.
Thank you.